Buonasera a tutti.
Good evening. Good evening. Thank you for having accepted our invitation to participate in this meeting that is connected to a series of meetings that we were having during these 2 weeks that we call the Protagonism in Sicily. It's an interesting experience because Sicily is having some comparisons with the other realities in the other regions of Italy, but also with other countries. During these weeks, we have the possibility to have some comparisons with the other, some discussions with other foreign speakers on health, on way of life, on technological innovation, agriculture, all topics that are related to this big expo project, Feed the Planet. And every single region presented and represented in these topics in many sectors, not only the agricultural sector. And Sicily outlined this topic from the point of view of the mental education, so what it means to build some new models starting from the topic of food. Today, as you all know, we will talk about this interesting topic, the Mediterranean boundary. So we have the presence of big speakers and that will manage the topic of boundaries. And we will enjoy for a couple of hours these discussions by enriching our knowledges. So I'd like to thank you, and I immediately will give the floor to my colleague, Assessor Bruno Caruso, representing the topic of Mediterranean boundaries for Sicily. He is the official representative of this issue and of this meeting today here in Expo. Thank you. I've always worked on migration for my job as a researcher, but I took this task of assessor, so I think that the issue must be known in its sense, not just the social and sociological and economic and cultural activities. I live in Catania, but during this period I work in Palermo. And in Palermo, I saw some scenes of the historical center of Palermo where migrants coexist in terms of real integration with the inhabitants of the historical center of Palermo. And so I thought that apart from the thoughts that we could have from a political and social and economic point of view on the topic, I thought that showing what could be the correct attitude to migration through a communicative construction through the pictures that a good friend of mine took. I really enjoyed what he did. And I thought that in order to introduce the discussion, maybe it would have been necessary to let you understand what we are doing, what's the material, what's the matter, the human matter that we are using, in order to improve our discussion from a political point of view also. I think that communication is beautiful and is the best way of improving our relationship, relating to our realities. So I wanted to give you some messages, and I would invite you to take a look at this video and then discuss on the topic. The topic is entitled and inspired, and has inspired the video, From the Boundaries to the Bridges. So talking about boundaries in the Mediterranean area is connected to an idea of closing and control crossing, and instead the bridges indicate the possibility to discuss, to have some discussions. And children are able to discuss, so that would be the topic of this video, and I will invite you to take a look at it.
Oh, sta mara di sorori, menzao di montagne, corre grere, senza che un filiciato è, pensi cosa pi quando, finisci un scanto un giorno, un mese, di sempre una. La Samara di sorori, menzao di montagne.
È stato fatto in pochissimo tempo.
So it was, this video is on the Oratorio dei Salesiani. We have other pictures that are interesting. I met in a group of people from Senegal. And they were playing cards as we did in the past, as our elderly did in the past, and they were chatting. And this is the real answer for an integration in a difficult city as Palermo. And Palermo is a city that is facing the tensions of the arrivals in this place, and so this could be the best answer for every cry, for every attempt to introduce some elements of hate, intolerance, and political speculation. And I think that this is the first step, and then we will be able to organize every political discussion on the difficulties of the moment. This is a starting point. Sicily and the Mediterranean Sea cannot be a symmetry. And in Sicily, we experimented the memories of the Mediterranean areas, because the Mediterranean area is a land of souvenirs. It's a land of work and combination of cultures. So seeing these banners as a message for Italy to the world is very sad. And This means betraying our way of managing the problem of migration, because Sicily is a land of migrants, and we exported many immigrants. And this is connected to a series of lies and these lies are connected to the phenomenon of the intensity of the landings that are not taken into account into the right way. So the figures concerning Italy and concerning the presence of foreign people have lower percentages than in the rest of Europe and the world. We have 8% of immigration, and Spain 16%, France 12%, etc. So this is a slide that tells us something from a statistical point of view on a long time, a long period, that we are together with Ireland, the people that recorded the major number of migrants. We have 40 million migrants, 2/3 of the population, and the Ireland is above us, above Italy. Yes, we have that problem. It exists. The migration in Italy and Spain has increased in a huge way. But then we have to say that we are the country with the lowest rate of birth, and we have a problem of coverage of a problem related to the interstices in terms of work, but the concentration of the phenomenon and the vacillation of this phenomenon sometimes is not good and creates some alarms, creates some concerns. And for the first time in public spaces, I heard Sicilian people talk in a worried way. For the first time, we mentioned Salvini, and in the past, we didn't even know who it was. And now, the fact that they all know who is Salvini is creates some concerns, because the Lega Nord party in Italy was ignored in the southern part of Italy. And now, the messages of Salvini find some appeals. So we should counteract this situation. We do not have to scream out our lies. We have to say the truth, and Italy needs migrants. And Italy needs a flow of migrants of at least 300,000 units per year in order to keep the international GDP. We need migrants. And many works are fundamental for our civil life. And without migrants, we would have some huge troubles from an economic point of view, especially. So what about the excessive cost of migrants? This is not true. We have a positive outcome. And this slide shows that pretty clearly. Is from the point of view of the GDP, what we earn in terms of revenues is quite high and is more than the cost that we have. So this is clear. We have a globalized economy, and this phenomenon is necessary for the development. We have other figures. The IDES has the same trend. Another lie that we should fight. Migrants are the responsible for the lack of jobs for Italian people, but this is not true. The migrants are present in every sector that is fundamental, and they are fundamental for our economy. If tomorrow we would decide to expel our migrants, our economy would go down, and we would have many billions of losses. So we know that the migrants make a job that the Italian people refuse. So maybe there's a problem of the control, there's the illegal work in the agricultural sector, and we are trying to work on this topic. And then they make dangerous jobs, so we have many people that die during the job place, and usually they're migrants. So that's the conclusion, supported by economic and statistical and social investigations that I resumed in this slide.
So
So this is to show you in figures how this is to show you that we need migrants. So we would have many sectors that would enter a big crisis without migrants, which is the problem. Why today we are suffering, and why Salvini is having a weight today. The problem is the one of the boundaries. It's how to transform our boundaries into bridges. There's the volunteer job that is the best expression for the subsidiarity, but this doesn't mean that a country doesn't have responsibilities. The Italian state had a better organization facing the problem without organization, without systematic aspects, and it's a generous people. Nobody can say the contrary. We have magnificent prefect and operators in the healthcare system. I know that because I live it on a daily basis. My wife manages boundaries and things like this. So these are examples that work so hard in order to improve the situation. But then we have situations, we have people that are not able to manage the complex character of this situation. Prefects that are continuously having crisis. And this is because our system is not organized, is not rational. We have a lack of input. We have a lack of planning. In Sicily, we have a trouble, for example, the welcome of children. For example, we have a distribution of the welcome centers decided from the bureaucracy. So we have more children than in the other regions. And we have actually just a few structures to welcome them. So it would be easy to solve. You don't need to have a decision maker on that, but we should modify this and launching a complicated procedure. So we still have this problem. So what do we have to do in Sicily? Thanks to the Constitutional Court, concern welfare, the housing, the work policies are managed by some regions. So Sicily wasn't equipped on that. We are a lack of specific organization. And in some way, we are welcoming the message of the Constitutional Court that decided in favor of the region on the discussion on competencies in terms of migration. So we have some skills in terms of welcome attributed to the state, and instead the policies towards migrants, towards people, the social policies are managed by the region. So in order to avoid troubles, we want to take the policies on migrants as a mainstream, as a link between social and active policies of work. So we created a special office on migration in Sicily that will be a kind of bridge between the various, among the well, between the skills, so production activities, tourism, agriculture, etc., because migration is a complete context. We work on many sectors, the one you see here, for example, the enterprises of migrants, but actually we are trying to use a holistic system that allows us to create a series of policies that could be used on the law of migration, and I would like it to be the most advanced in Italy. Sometimes it is good to be the last ones, because you can use the experiences of the other ones. So we created this office, and that's the huge agenda that we have, that Nicole, and this is how Nicole would mention it. Thank you.
Allora, sono Aldo Bonomi.
So my name is Aldo Bonomi. I accompany Italian territories within Expo. So I strongly wanted and desired this seminar with the coordination of the regions, which everyone approved. I would like to explain very briefly why I strongly desired this seminar. First of all, from 2013 to today, I went around Italy with Mr. De Rita to promote Italy. 91-92, I went around Italy on behalf of the first conference on immigration. It was the first and the last one, and I remember that I went to Trapani to deal with immigration topics. And I have to say that, as far as I'm concerned, I found a great change between what I did in 1991 and today on two big themes. One of the big themes, issues, coming also from the fact that we had one first and last international conference on immigration, is that the phenomenon which happened on the borders was, from my point of view, a dramatic phenomenon. And so I asked to include in Expo issues topics also the topic of borders, refugees, and immigration, because I believe that this issue is strictly linked to Expo issues to feed the planet energy for life. And I recall an officer, a colleague of Linda, always makes fun of me. I went around the territories and I said, the problem is not chef of the old world, get united and bring to Expo not only the salamelle or other products. But this officer was teasing me because he said, you went around saying, let's talk about content, but then we come here, and next to me I have salame citerio or prosciutto ferrarini. Then from this point of view, he's right. He's right. It is not my responsibility. The aesthetics and the size of the place is not my responsibility. Anyway, I'm convinced that the problem is, in spite of salame citerio, together with salame citerio and prosciutto ferrarini, together with these two products, it is important to include also the issue of content. And so I suggested to organize a seminar promoted by Sicily Region. And I thank Sicily Region for playing the role of head of the project on this very delicate issue. It is better to come here and promote tourism, cultural heritage, the beauties, wheat, durum wheat or soft wheat, rather and so how to attract more people in Sicily. But we cannot talk about development models without taking into account these important issues. And so I thank you because you accepted my desire. So I suggested to organize this meeting. I believe that on this topic, compared to 1991-92, in which the problem was a historical mutation of the country, which from immigration country became an immigration country. The problem of immigration in 1991-92 through Martelli law was a problem which concerned immigration, working immigration for work. And so we identified, we analyzed this problem from an employment point of view, but now the world has changed. The problem is not only if the problem is not only the employment, and you were right at explaining the data which immigrants produce. But the problem today is different. In the Mediterranean area, in my opinion, there are those which I call places of a rupture. So these places are what happens in Lampedusa and what happens every day in the central station in Milan. So these are the big points, or Ventimiglia. These are those fault places, the places of a big break, of big rupture. So inside this issue, development models, Europe, are so all these issues are strictly linked with the problem of immigration. And so I suggested Sicily region to organize a very simple round table, a debate between those who are in the Mediterranean border and those who are in the Milanese border, for example. And so I have organized this round table in a very simple way. A Sicilian and a Milanese, so a person from Sicily and a person from Milan. So the first two people can come here, Domenico Mugavero, Bishop of Mazara del Vallo, and Gad Lerner, who's been adopted by the city of Milan. And then right after them, Maria Rosanna Danna, Hospital Bucheri, La Ferla in Palermo. Just wanting to add that Councillor Purpura, Cultural Heritage, has been able to come here, so we have to put him in list. Then Maria Rosanna Danna and Don Colmenia, and Virginio Colmenia, then Viviana Villastro, and then Councillor Maiorino, and the councillor who had just arrived. So we can proceed in this way, but as we went, so we, I give the floor to Bishop, to the Bishop. Good evening. I'm very pleased for your choice tonight, because giving such a dignity to the issue of immigration seems to solve a methodology issue, first of all. That is, we must not talk about immigration in terms of emergency, and we must consider that this fact is something inevitable, and it belongs to us. So You were talking about the rupture, the breaks, of the breakage. I can say that immigration, and everyone must make some choices, and must make some choices on this topic. So I believe that immigration raises three challenges, and afterwards I will identify four perspectives. But I'm not going to be long. So the first challenge is an identity challenge. I believe that immigration scares us because it poses a problem which questions us today as Italians in our identity profiles. And as we are in contact with people who show a strong identity, and an identity which has a big human and anthropological identity, and I'm referring to the people who are Muslims, for whom the religious component, which we must always distinguish between the religious and practical component, as a very identity element. So they don't understand our lack of religiosity, or the attempt which is done in the United Europe to marginalize the religious fact. They don't understand this, and so they question themselves and they question us. So the confrontation with the migrants arises an identity problem, especially to the Sicilians. And I welcome what Town Councillor Caruso was saying. If up to now our people have always been open, have always shown solidarity, and they have never marginalized migrants by making a lot of efforts and working hard to welcome them in every city, Lampedusa, Ragusa, Pozzallo, Palermo, Trapani, Mazara, all our people do a lot for migrants. Today, there is doubt. Sicilians have some doubts because the messages, based on the slogan rather than on the serious arguments, especially if they are aimed at causing other doubts and other fears, lead to some changes, identity changes. And today, so we have an identity challenge. Who are we? And this is said by someone whom in his blood, especially if we look at the history of the great years of Sicily, we just need to mention Frederick II. So he said a civilization and a culture in which the language didn't exist, the languages existed, because the diversity of languages was not a problem which hampered communication, but enriched it. Second of all, immigration poses a cultural challenge. Today, we cannot neglect the fact that diversity is always there, and diversity asks us to extend our horizons. We are tempted to consider a framework of values as given, and we don't have some references, especially for what is new. Today, with the earthquake which Pope Francis brought to the people, we have troubles following him, because his presence, his gestures, which are the most immediate form of magistry, so our tendency to not moving and not doing anything is disturbed. So the migrant, the issue of immigration arises a cultural challenge which we refuse, which we reject, because the models we acquired are reassuring and they allow us to live in a relaxed way. The new things questions what we have. And this challenge today, Italy, Sicily, Europe must take this challenge. This is important for the future, because the Western world has troubles accepting that it is no longer at the center of the world. The center of the world has moved. And if we do not accept this big challenge, cultural challenge, we risk being left behind. So it's useless to say that it is the fault of China, India, or other countries, because we need to defend ourselves and protect ourselves. I'm going Ed, if you have any remarks, you can tell them. You can talk to me. The third challenge is a project challenge. Today, we running after current events, and we are very concerned about figures. In the province of Trapani, the prefect, in the last 3 years, brought the reception for migrants to a double amount without admitting any tolerance against speculations, because there were symptoms of bad actions were seen, and I'm not going to mention Mafia Capitale or something like that. Well, we didn't achieve such a point, but the preventive method is good, because when the problem is still small, we don't have to do many things to solve it. So we pretend to solve this problem alone, and Italy could, and this could be comfortable for Italy. But working together to plan something which, first of all, identifies the problem of a problem which is not only a problem of landing. Some years ago, when wars and revolutions had not changed the framework, the 60,000 migrants who came to Italy through the Mediterranean Sea, according the Ministry of the Interior, represented 20% of illegal immigration. I've never understood how against 20% there is a general mobilization of everyone against a fraction which is just 1/5 of the whole phenomenon, and against 80%, and this is said by official estimates rather than estimates given by the charity field. So I've never understood why 80% has never said anything, but the 20% has caused so many problems. Now the figures are different, so the ratios are different, but the questions are worse and they've increased. So there is a project challenge. I mean, we are dealing with a big reality in front of which we lack tools, perspectives. The first perspective comes from the fact that diversity is not a danger, but it is a resource. And this is something which is strictly linked to globalization. We cannot pretend that globalization is something which media or talk show may deal with. Globalization has entered any aspects of cultural, social, and religious life, and all these leads to the fact that complexity is a reality with which we have to deal every day. So if we can understand by referring to figures and phenomena that diversity is a resource, then the issue of immigration could be faced in a different way. In the project to which we are participating today, tells us that the critical aspect of the presence of the migrant has become a resource for a project which has made it possible to meet at the Sicilian bakery and the North African bakery, especially Tunisian and Moroccan bakery. So this is a micro initiative which has shown how from this critical situation of different presences, a project could be developed which allows for the meeting of these people, of these cultures. So instead of removing jobs, create jobs for locals and for migrants. The second perspective is the importance we must give to education. We cannot start from adults. We cannot pretend that adults change their perspective and their state of mind. I see that in our schools, where we have local children and immigrant children, is a daily fact. The problem of diversity does not exist. The problem of dialogue, the problem of equal opportunities does not exist in schools. If we follow the educational route and we start from young generations, if we think that in these regards nothing can be given to nothing can be done by hazard, we have a way to address this issue with a perspective which allows for the creation of an identity model, which is that of the Homo Mediterraneus. When today we talk about Euro-Mediterranean, I laugh inside of me because I wonder what it means when this word is pronounced by an English person, a Norwegian person, an Italian person. Where does the Euro-Mediterranean go? Where does this concept go? this is a very complex fact, and we just create slogans, but this is not serious. So the importance of the educational factor to start from young generations and to start to change the trend starting from young people in order to establish a real Mediterranean identity. Third perspective is a pontifical perspective. It's conviviality. Pope Benedict XVI spoke about this in the document of Middle Eastern churches when he spoke about conviviality between Christians and Jews, between Christians and Muslims, between Jews and Muslims, and Jews and Christians. So we do not sit at the same table when we are enemies. We sit at the same table when we have something in common, when we have many things in common. And just to go back to Milan and to Expo, food as a great sacral, holy meaning in religion. Religions. The Easter evening in Judaism, the legislation on food, which seems ridiculous, both in Judaism and in Islam, Eucharisty, which is a feast. So the category of conviviality, Pope Francis, in launching the Jubilee, underlined that the merciful God, the God of Jews, the God of Christians, the God of Muslims, on mercy, he wants to create religious dialogue which does not have any apologetic purposes. God is one and is one for everyone. When I told a priest of my diocese that we are all brothers and sisters because we are all children of God, told me, yes, we are brothers and sisters, but children of God until a certain point. And I told him, no, we are all the same children. Otherwise, what kind of God can make children of different classes and different importance? So conviviality, we must try that which can become an element of sharing in faith and in humanity. And so the role which religions and interreligious dialogue can have in dealing with the issue of migration under the plenary point of view of the human importance. And one last element, the value of micro projects, where the small things which we do have a pedagogically high value, because they told us that if we can stay together, if the horizon grows, we are always the same. Saint Paul says that men are always the same, but when I was a child, I used to think as a child, I used to speak as a child, I used to act as a child. When I became an adult, it's always me, but I act, I think as an adult. So we are always the same person, but if we took the right direction, we can go far away. So today, migration gives us an important and big challenge, which is a cultural challenge, which I would like to summarize in a formula which I fell in love with which I conclude my speech. I believe that the challenge which migration gives us is to re-elaborate a Mediterranean humanism, which is the one which has always linked those who have lived on this sea and those who want to give a testimony of progress, development and peace in this Mediterranean area. Thank you. Before giving the floor to Gad, I apologize because I didn't mention this. Maiorino, Mr. Maiorino and Mr. Morcone, who deal with immigration on the territory, are going to talk.
Velocissimo, buon.
Very rapidly. Good evening. Finally, the directive of Bonomi to be Milanese, to talk to Sicilians, so ignoring the ironies that we could make on my birthplace, I will focus on one thing in particular. I will be very short because I acknowledge myself in the words of the Bishop of Mazara del Vallo. And if I have to put those words in a sociological way, I would use one term, one expression. I don't know if he will enjoy that, but maybe it's more familiar to Bonomi. I would say that the concern around the figure of the migrant, the hysteria, collective hysteria that we have by increasing those phenomena that are physiological, all these is connected to a deep truth that is terrifying. And this truth is that we perceive, we understand in the social figure of a migrant the protagonist of the social conflicts of the contemporary era. So it's in the center of our world, of every social conflict. So we can call them in many ways, but I understand that even though when we are talking about four people in Ventimiglia, they seem threatening group. I understand this sense of threat. And I also understand, and here I address the Sicilians, I understand the reaction that wants to say stop, that things that can join the Italian people in the fight against this threat. And this was connected to the phenomena of the Lega Nord party. And I think that in cultural terms, it's good to talk about fascio leghismo in Italian, so the national reivindications, the languages of strength. And the bad thing that I want to say is that in some countries, on the immigration, it could prevail the line of contention. So let's try to create some walls, as some governments started to do. In that case, do not be offended. You would be on the other side of the wall, you, the Sicilians, because you would be the members of the body cut away in order to, in the vision of saving our continent. I don't know, it's not that good to hear that, but this is what happens. And the illusion that we have to move back in the boundary if we want to safeguard the levels of well-being that we had in the past. So it's an illusion. That's what I think, but maybe it's coherent. And in this coherence, the regions of our southern south in Italy are living the same conditions of Greece in terms of consumptions, in terms of unemployment, and in terms of social lack of integration and work among poor people. So they are part of a Mediterranean area that is considered as high. I participated in a workshop in big Italian and international companies. And these companies are trying to fight the collapse of consumptions, and they are studying some special cost for food and some different labels for the north of Italy. So that's a huge problem. So you, despite the political attempt that is quite very understandable to regroup an insular nationalism against the foreign people, maybe you would be outside of that, and so it would be difficult to cut these parts of Italy. And the Mediterranean Sea is crossed by those who go away, those refugees escaping some bad realities. But the Mediterranean Sea is crossed by oleoducts, and without these elements, the lowest part of Italy would have some troubles. So the answer to this energetic need that Libya mentioned a lot, so the answer, the unique answer that we can imagine in the vision of the contention is, and the containment, is what we think. So let's put some dictators, let's rethink the entire policy on the South River of the Mediterranean Sea through some figures of colonization and submission of those people. And if these provoked a social fire, if these means facing the jihadist threat in these regions, so the logic, the perspective becomes a war perspective. So I am depicting a somber framework. I'm not that optimist, but despite all this, the amalgam is real, so the Euro-Mediterranean region, from a geographical point of view, the regions of Europe bordering on the southern river of our sea, have a relationship with what happens on the other side. So maybe these is the only possibility to move away from this crisis through the affirmation of some specific points, and one is the most important, in my opinion. Because discussing on this possibility to manage these values of faith also, these are in the hand of the managing classes. The event of Ineo is devastating for all those who know the idea of solidarity, for all those who know the notion of welfare, of universal welfare. So the way in which we manage the financing of policies on the immigration is clear that needs to be questioned. I won't say, I would not say any name, but I know some institutions that didn't want to host refugees because they were afraid of those 35, 40 euros per person and the way of attributing this money. So these must be overcome. And what we have is trying to give ourselves a main principle. And politics has a lot of troubles in applying this principle. It's paradoxical that the Laudato Si encyclical today quantifies, today is has sold more than 40,000 copies. So there are many journalists in many Italian newspapers or members of Palazzo Chigi or I don't know anyone else. We wanted to discuss that encyclical. We want to talk about that on migrants. And let's try to refer to talk about one principle that maybe will be just a utopia, that maybe will be that maybe we have some negative result. And I will mention the conventions on human rights and other conventions. So we have some political basis to say that this, the freedom of movement of man, is a holy principle. And this holy principle is related to the principle that we cannot be condemned because we were born in a particular place. So this is something that cannot be touched. This is, and we are talking about the free movement of merchandise and goods, and it's not acceptable that the free movement of man is not what happens. So we do not have to make some step to move back, to come back to the past. Thank you, God. Now I would like to introduce Maria Rosa Danna. Just a couple of comments of what you said. Among the economists, they discuss a lot in the north of circular economy. And with this, they mean the issue of fighting against waste, etc. And I am convinced that if the circular economy of the Mediterranean area doesn't work well, so the circulation, first of all, of men and then merchandise, then the speech of the circular economy won't continue to grow. So I agree with God, and I would like Mr. Maiorino to take it into account. I am witnessing that the rancor before was against those who were different from ourselves, and now is related to all those who manage the other people. So this is quite a delicate issue. And I think that we can feel it on our skin. And in order to be clear, that's the bad event of Rome, Mafia Capitale. That's a very bad event. So we have some associations that are considered in a negative way because they are managing those people. Thanks to the organizers, thanks to the assessors, Caruso, Purpura, Bancheri. I am very honored to be here to participate in this beautiful and interesting meeting on topics that I live, that I daily live. I am a doctor responsible for the child department of the hospital Buccheri La Ferla in Palermo. And we are managing the refugee camp in front of the hospital, and then the weak parts of our populations. And the hospital represents the first birthplace of Sicily, 205 childbirth every year, and we have patients that are refugees, and I will show you a video on our job with these patients. I just wanted to outline to say how much I appreciated the intervention of Mr. Caruso, who said that childbirth in Sicily is decreasing. We are approaching the limit in which the civilization disappears, and this is the limit that is not that far. Our patients, the female patients that we have every day, are 40 years old. There are obese patients. There are patients that had some medical problems. And the only young patients that we have are extracommunitary patients. And they have more than one child. And the local female women have one child in average. The other trouble that I wanted to mention is the topic of the pregnant woman. It's an event full of emotions and fears, and we need to be brave in that for everybody, and especially for a patient coming from a long journey that was raped. Many patients are raped in these boats because many people think that they are fragile, and so they cannot leave traces on these patients. And for these patients, we have always created some paths of aid concerning the phases of pregnancies through some courses in order to be prepared to the childbirth and in order to integrate their culture with our culture. And there's an integration, there's a richness coming from this integration that is quite unique. The respect of the culture through the cultural mediators, they are very helpful in our job. And then the migrant patient is fragile, is more fragile than the other women because it's the first time that she has an active role. Usually, the woman didn't leave her country and waited for the man to come back. And now she is active and she is humiliated very often. And she leaves one of the most beautiful moments in the life of a person, the childbirth, in such situations. I would like to show you the video and then I will conclude.
Intanto
the founder of the hospital San Giovanni di Dio says a lot on the welcome that we have.
Paziente che è arrivata col bambino morto.
This patient arrived with a child who had died, unfortunately.
Grazie.
Thank you. I thank you all. And I thank you on behalf of those who collaborate with me, of the departments, the sections of childbirth. We have 23 doctors and many other operators, support operators, and they're all in the picture. This is the day of my birthday.
No, lo dico a Dobonomi, c'è il tasso di sigarette che deve fumare. Volevo proprio partire da alcune sollecitazioni che venivano da Monsignor Mogavero.
So I'd like to start by recalling the relationship with Sicily. If we look at the first, the first video was made of faces and stories, the topic of the face, of the dignity, becomes very, very important, because the great cultural attack which is taking place in this phase is to destroy the feelings of humanity. And it is a very strong crisis. We can say that every person has a dignity. We are learning in the northern regions, we are learning this thanks to the extraordinary experience of Sicilian people. When my operators went to Lampedusa, the cry of the fisherman when he went and rescued the victims with Mrs. Cristina Cattaneo, who is living together with other people to identify the victims, having no names in those coffins. These are these are stories of humanity which enters our daily life in the cities, and I believe this must cross a reality like Expo, where the consumption processes, the processes of globalization, cross all borders, and we are assisting an identity an identity issue where borders become separation, so aggressive identity. So the risk in this phase which we are experiencing, so we are experiencing this paradox to make everything an emergency. So we call them refugees, they come, they leave, so there is no name, there are no names, these people have no names. We saw their bodies tortured, which have been tortured, because when they reach the boat, they have already made a long journey. So there is a lack of capacity to transfer this impetus of humanity, which is not only that to bring clothes, but it is an extraordinary response which we must make culturally winning, whereas now it is defending itself against the aggressive attack, because I cannot we cannot accept conditions such as closing refugee camps. We must establish a culture that makes it possible to solve the problem. We do not want the problem to stay. So those persons who come here become people, become men, women, and children who must be used in their misery. I've been insisting on this point. Beyond the extraordinary things we can do, we must reflect upon how the feelings of humanity can become predominate on a policy that goes to the other direction. This is one of the most important elements which we must focus on, as Mr. Caruso was saying. When we go on the subway, on the public transportation, we hear people that have a long tradition of welcoming people. So the problem is coming from the bottom. So this incapacity, this lack of capacity to grasp the problem. So it is a cultural fact which enters our daily life. It needs normal responses of quality of investment, of assessment of results. We must tell these experiences in significant terms. The tale is never enough, because what they are experiencing is a destruction of humanity. Listening to people talking about figures, just figures, figures which are absurd, which are absurd, really absurd. So I believe that also entrepreneurial world has a responsibility. It has to detach itself from this culture, which there is a silence from entrepreneurial class, which legitimates these spaces, which are spaces which question, because it's destroying the capital of economy, of development. The topic of citizenship must become fundamental, because these are people. Migratory phenomenon is a phenomenon, is a fundamental phenomenon. We always talk about foreigners, but these are people that have been here for two generations, three generations. We have not been able to win the battle of the youth solely, and this debate we have put aside this debate, and sometimes we just risk to respond to aggressive attitudes, and so we know that rules are fundamental to solve this issue. So this is a very serious issue, because we can see anything, the capacity of policies of administrators who go there and help, showing great humanity, and they report the weakness of the politics to solve these problems. And the other only politics seems to close the aggressive spaces, and so they use the fact of the central station, which has become a place of poverty, by saying, look, the conditions in which these people are left. So the politics should be responsible, politicians should be responsible for this. So there is a huge contradiction, which we cannot transform into an aggressive responsibility. It is not the agenda of the problem. It must not be established by those who believe that the phenomenon is an emergency, by promoting fears, and they cross us. We have fears inside, we live with fears, but we will need a human culture which is able to take fear in its hands, and to see that there is a limit in politics. Migratory phenomena of 50 million, another hidden state, this migratory phenomenon which characterizes all nations. So what kind of response do we give? We just give a separate response, but this is a central issue of economic policy. It is a priority to experience in logics in which borders must be removed. We must become bridges rather than barriers. And I conclude on this. I believe that there is a need to not to consider it as an emergency. We are experiencing the hypocrisy. We are fighting a lot about the shares, etc. And we are experiencing a situation which is not being dealt with as a normal problem. And this is important. It is important to show that when we intervene with a public policy, which is clear policy, in this way we can establish a culture of citizenship, of dignity. Of course, if the UN, of course, This is it. We can discuss about anything, but these are principles of civilization, which cannot be voluntary. They are the foundations of a society that can establish an economic development. But now we have faced the risk to make them poor, and this issue of poverty. It rises a responsibility on problem, which is our problem. In the faces we see, there is a tragedy, but there is also the issue of Syria, of Libya, of the journeys they make, the issue of Eritrea, Somalia, the African continent. So there is a cultural poverty to deal with these issues, which is huge. And on the contrary, it is a great resource. And one last remark. We should recover, just as the previous video says, which shows the treatment and the assistance we can give. But now they are trying to remove this culture of assistance as the capacity to rebuild the meaning of life, the capacity to rebuild. We are overwhelmed by problems which are small problems and could be dealt with just a rational feeling, but they are used to bring us to a selfish culture. The culture that generates fear is a culture which is not able to manage the situations, the existing situations of what happens. And so we must safeguard the quality. Of course, mafia capitale is a concern for everyone, not only because there was an economic speculation, but because we can see that there wasn't an idea to rebuild solidarity, but there was a private commercial interest, a dramatic interest, where everyone had to exploit this situation. And so social policies must be policies which require results, excellence and quality. There is the number of people arriving among the people who come here. They have a very difficult story. They have many psychological problems. They need a special assistance, a special treatment. We need quality in the intervention.
Ultimo dibattito.
Last debate before the conclusions on the two fault places. So Viviana Valastro, Save the Children, and Luciano Gualzetti, Caritas Ambrosiana, Milan, Vice Commissioner, Vatican Pavilion in Expo. I have a presentation, so I need the remote. First of all, thank you for the invitation, for the opportunity you gave me to speak about the situation of migrant children. One of the most vulnerable groups is women, pregnant women, and Save the Children is focuses on another vulnerable group: children, teenagers, especially children traveling alone. I know that Prefect Morcone is going to give updated data on migrants arriving via the sea, but I would like to anticipate one figure, which is an estimate, just to give you an idea of the current size of the phenomenon. At the beginning of 2015 to today, more than 70 migrants arrived and 6,800 minors, and at least 4,300 traveled alone without an adult. Sicily region is the region which has seen the highest number of arrivals, because it has one of the harbors which is more appropriate to welcome the commercial boats which rescue migrants in the sea. If we look at last year, at 2014, just the municipality of Lampedusa, which has 36,000 inhabitants, has received the same amount of migrants. Who are these people? These people that arrive here. If we look at accompanied minors, there is a high number of children from Syria. So, starting from 2013, there was a very significant increase in the number of Syrian people and Syrian children. Syrian people that came with their family, enlarged family, so not only parents and children, but also uncle and grandparents, and so on, big families, just like us. So families that before the beginning of the conflict in Syria used to live a normal life. They were freelancers. They had an economic availability which allowed them to start this journey. What characterizes the arrival of Syrians, and they have demonstrated this, is the fact that they don't want to stay in our country. So for this reason, so this is the main reason why they do not want to leave their identity, not because, as we could easily say, they are all terrorists, but because they are just people who have a passport. They have no problems to show them. Just if they show them, they could have the possibility to go to countries such as Sweden or Germany, where some of their relatives live, and or friends with whom they can to whom they can go and can have a support, an economic support, but most of all an emotional support. So this is what they tell us. After we tell them their rights and duties, they do not want to give their identity. The other group of not accompanied children, minors, are minors from Eritrea. If you had the opportunity to see it personally, there are many children, many adolescents, so between 15 and 16 year old, but there are also younger children who left alone. They left Eritrea, a country which has a pavilion here in Expo, but has a military dictatorship, so it is a country from which people leave because they do not have any future, they're not free to express, they do not have the possibility to live freely as we can do in Italy and in Europe in general. Minors tell they are afraid they could be part of the army, and they are afraid that they don't know how long they will have to stay in the army, so they don't want to live such a life. They want to become lawyers, physicians, just like our adolescents, and so they start a journey which is incredible. When they tell you, when they show it on the map, they cross the border with Ethiopia, they go in refugee camp, and they hope to go to another country, but then they want to go earlier to this country, so they start a journey in the desert, but sometimes they are kidnapped by some groups which take them to Sinai Desert, so they need to have to receive a lot of money to leave these areas, and sometimes they are forced also to sell their organs just to be set free. So they are able to reach Libya, which is a country in which it is very difficult to live at the moment. So they are detained. They are subject to physical violence, and they see friends or other migrants having this violence. So after all this, they go on a boat and they come to Italy, and their objective is to go to other countries where they have friends, relatives. But unfortunately, in spite of Dublin regulation, which regulates the movement of migrants in Europe, in the case of non-accompanied minors, this type of transfers is very long. So when we tell them about their rights, and we tell them you have the possibility to go there if you have a brother, if you have a sister there, when they ask us, but how long do I need to go there? We tell them months. They thank us. They contact the person in charge of the trafficking, and they go to another country. If you are interested and use the social network, you can live, you can experience this journey through a Facebook profile, which is a fake profile but extremely true in its content. So there are some posts of a journey of a minor from Eritrea to Hamburgo. We have already said this. And also, as for the presence, not only the arrivals, Sicily region is the region which is the most involved. 2,650 are the minors reported to the ministry who are still present in several structures in Sicily. What happens to a minor who comes alone to Italy? First of all, he must be recognized as a minor. This is not always easy because they do not have their documents. They don't always have their documents, and they must demonstrate that they are alone, that they didn't travel with anyone. Because if they are alone, if they are not accompanied, based on the Italian regulation, they can stay in Italy without the need to ask for international protection. If they cannot be repatriated to their origin country, if they want to go back to their country, this is possible, but this must be something that they request. They cannot stay in centers together with adults, and as soon as possible, one person that represents them legally must be appointed, because they do not have any reference adult. They have the right to be welcomed if they have relatives in Italy or in other European countries. They have to be join them. So one situation which we experienced until last July is that in Italy there is no law which rules this time of arrival. So we just apply the legislation provided for Italian minors who are found alone in the street. So the Italian law states that the municipality where the minor is must deal with the minor. So this is the legislation which regulates the arrival of minors coming via the sea, who arrive here and are rescued by boats. This is So if 86 miners arrive in a landing in Augusta, then the municipality must understand where to locate these miners, and then they open schools which were closed, and this becomes an emergency. Then finding a place in a community is very difficult, and the situation, the conditions in the centers become very, very hard. And then there are many other things which seem just a detail but are very important. So there are people who are appointed as guardian of these miners. Imagine a city like Rome. There was the mayor, mayor at that time, the mayor Alemanno, who had was the guardian of more than 2,000 children. So this does not help the integration process of a minor coming to our country. Why do these children leave? In the cases of, but there are also there is also the case of Egyptians who move from the landing places to Rome and Milan, which are the cities in which they have reference points. So they have other people from their country that help them to enter the black market. So. This is something not appropriate to their age, but meet their need to have the necessary money to send home, and to have parents to pay the debt, and to reach their children and improve their life conditions. Of course, leaving is very dangerous for a children who's alone, especially if they do not leave any fingerprints. It means they are children that never came here. They are invisible children, and so there are many risks in terms of exploitation, involvement in illegal activities, and exploitation of minors. Even when we inform them about the situation at the border with Ventimiglia and the situation in Calais, they often cannot understand it. The need to reach those countries is stronger. Of course, there are important changes ongoing. One was the presentation of a proposal of law submitted by Save the Children, and which is at the moment under discussion at the Chamber of Deputies. The iter is quite long because there has been a negative opinion by the committee. But another important document of last July was published, in which we started to build a system which should replace this not appropriate legislation, which at the moment is applied for not accompanied minors. It is important to mention three fundamental elements. Through this understanding, a coordination is formed, a coordination structure at the Ministry of the Interior, and two levels of welcome have been established, a level of welcome of high specialization, and these places should be places in Italy which can welcome minors coming via the sea. And there is also an increase in the numbers of places which were reserved to not accompanied minors requesting asylum. Now they are given to all minors. It was important to mention Sicily region. So Sicily region is a region which has done a lot in the last years. Sicily has introduced the double level of welcome with regional legislation and activated 22 first welcome structures, 14 second welcome, and more than 400 communities, communities for minors, so important figures. I conclude with a reflection which is more political. Europe has demonstrated to pay more attention to what happens at the Italian borders, but has done it only after two tragedies. So there has been an action by the Europe, but Save the Children is aware of the difficulty to find a European agreement, but we believe that it is not possible to reach the summer without a clear policy, without a clear decision. Miners that come here try to tell their stories. They have stories which do not allow us to wait and to waste time. Thank you.
Bene, grazie.
Thank you. We have three conclusions, so I will try to be short. We don't have to waste time. I saw that there were some movements because of the hour. I would like to talk about some matters that are important to underline. I think that when we talk about migration, the fundamental problem is the representation. We have fundamental data that are clear. Today we have 250 million people migrating for many reasons, especially for troubles connected to a series of bad situations in their countries of origin. They go towards rich countries. We can recognize some of those people because they are refugees, approximately 42 million. And we ignore the fact that many of them are obliged to move away from their country for a series of causes connected to our system of development, especially concerning the responsibility of the rich countries. We are in Expo. We cannot forget that many people are expelled from their country because they don't have, they do not have a land, so there's the land grabbing movement situation. And if we take a look at the origins of the countries of people coming in Italy, we can see that there's a big incidence in those areas where many governments want those lands in order to produce those products, those foods that need to be used in our supermarkets, so those products that produce fuels for that hunger of energy that those countries have. And through processes of corruption, or rather purchase promoted by the weaknesses of the institutions of those countries, they remove these fundamental conditions for those people in order to survive. Today, they do not arrive on through boats, because in order to do that, you need to be brave, you need to have money. So many Caritas all over the world told that they had to acknowledge the rights to those people in order to have this fundamental element that is the land, and they work with migrants in those countries. The other factor concerning this kind of model is climate change. We have 32 million people migrating, leaving their land for the desertification or for phenomena big, such as earthquakes or famines that are connected to their countries. So this is what we denounce in the encyclical, for example. We have a situation that could be compared to the nuclear catastrophe. And this is not a case that in the encyclical we mentioned the Pacem in Terris. So in the 60s, that was the terror, the humankind had the destiny in its own hands through nuclear weapons. And today, the humankind has in its own hands the destiny, because with the climate change, we are reaching a point of no return, and the effects are creating some situations for bad situation for those who cannot be defended, and we have a collapse for everybody. And today we have 32 million people that are expelled from their land because of these situations. One of the proposals that we made in this expo was to reconsider in the international laws this situation of escaping from the countries. And I say that because the issue of the representation shows that we should help them. And if we do that in this way, they will continue leaving their countries. And rather, we should face this thing that is structural by creating some bad situation. So this is not the right way to do that. Because the illegal people are those who, having a title, having a job, they lose a job, and so they are illegal again after having a job. And so this situation should be managed in a different way. So we need to have a different way of solving this situation, and we need to have some stronger institutions that are not afraid of managing this issue by creating some different conditions. Politics today is working in a bad way. It's not a matter of creating fears, it's a matter of facing the situations in a serious way by creating some paths that could be manageable. And one of the attempts of Europe is to move, as Gerd Lehner said, the boundary, maybe thought about a culture that we are witnessing. So we are trying to move the situation in the north. I'm sorry for our Sicilians that felt excluded, but actually Europe is trying to bring this boundary in the south. And we saw that the attempt was to find some agreements in order to put some hubs in the desert of Tunis. So some camps in the south part of the country, but these trajectories do not find a precise line, but maybe sometimes we forget that there's a bigger Mediterranean area. So we should eliminate those barriers, we should face those causes, climate change, land grabbing, and other things that depend on the choices that we make. And I would stop here. Thank you. Last two interventions, Maiorino and Morcone. And then I will leave, and then the conclusions of the assessor of Sicily. Who's the first? I'll be the first. The central state is the Sicily. So rapidly, I'm very honored to be here for many reasons. I would like to thank Aldo and the Sicily region that gave us this opportunity of discussion. We discussed about these topics in Expo. It's the second time that I discuss in an initiative organized by Sicily during the Expo. It happened for clear reasons a few weeks ago to have an intervention during an important debate on mafias. And I believe that it's a good way of thinking about this platform of discussion and dialogue. And maybe the Lombardy region would have to think about that. And I believe that it's very interesting, this dialogue between cities and boundary lands, and it would be positive to have the ambition to continue to create some connections. So it would be nice to be connected. Our experience says administration we heard the voice of Caritas Ambrosiana and the speech of Don Virginio. We, as administration of the municipality, we have to manage in the summer of 2011 the emergency of North Africa, and from the October 2013 we had a complex situation concerning the refugees coming from Syria, for example. More than 70,000 in a period of 20 months, and we gave aid to those people, and so we built a network between local bodies, third sector, active citizenship, with a huge protagonism of volunteers. I would like to express everything in this occasion. Maybe we didn't choose the migration. We chose not to choose, and we are trying to reduce the damage. And this kind of attitude is shown through many episodes of lack from a political point of view. And this is the extraordinary gift that we could give to those who try to rebuild in an efficient way on the matter of migration and the capacity of attracting citizens through the political success. We can see we can say that choosing not to choose is a bad situation. We had a semester of presidency, as you all know, and we had an extraordinary role as government in terms of relationships of power in the continental context. So choosing not to choose today means, after having said in Europe with a weak voice, so the need to have a differentiations on the continental policies on such on this issue, we didn't face the decomposition of migration in our country. If we take a look at what happened on the other hand of the Mediterranean area, but we also have to think about what is happening here in this side of the Mediterranean area. Because yesterday, for example, we recorded 187 migrants. Tonight we will have 1,500 people in Milan. And this means that these are refugees in transit. So we didn't invent this issue when the matter of diseases emerge, such as scabies. So this topic is well known. We didn't modify the rules of Dublin on the agreements of Dublin. And moreover, we didn't adjusted their modification, so we chose not to identify them because they go away. And so we let them come. And this transit is made through illegal passages. So I believe that there is an institutional responsibility. I apologize for saying that, and because these topics should be managed by our politics, that is the real responsible of this commission. There are those people who try to manage this framework, the emergency that we are facing, but we witness some paradoxical situations. We all know what is happening. For example, refugees from Syria or Eritrea coming, landing, living for some days in Sicily or Puglia. In some cases, maybe they're identified. They cross the country and they arrive by saying that they were invited to go away, to leave, by the representatives of the countries operating in the centers of Sicily or Puglia that have too many people in their centers. And so they are pushed towards the other areas. So this event tells an underestimation that is extraordinary, a lack of preparation, and the politics is responsible, so we need to use some different instruments, because otherwise we cannot continue handling this topic meeting after meeting. I will use the table, so I have a small proposal. The matter has been handled through instruments that are not efficient, so let's decide to do that through a human corridor. Let's take the responsibility to do that in the metropolitan area of Milan. We could do that. We could create some other poles in the country. by using these structures that we have, lungs that allow the concentration of those people. And this concerns people. This doesn't concern a problem that should be hidden. I am convinced that all the right consideration that we made in the first part of this complex round table that we are having today, compared to the choice that we should have in terms of value of welcome, we know how to support them, to support those policies, if we can evoke them and if we can manage these troubles. And we have to work. We have to say that the flows are evident. We cannot discuss about that. And we are facing the need of creating some centers of permanent welcome. And we all know that we could face this situation if we change the instruments that we are using. So I'm convinced that tomorrow will be as today. I'm convinced that anything will change, nothing will change, because we don't have some policies to change the situation. I know that I cannot wait for the authorization of Mrs. Merkel for the management of our refugees in Sicily or Italy or Milan, because we need to take the responsibility of how to welcome those people in the sea, but also in the other possible ways. So we have the huge topic of migrations, and we need to handle those migrations with a different strategy. Thank you.
Io intanto davvero di cuore
I would like to thank Sicily and Milan for having offered this evening of thoughts on a topic that sometimes is unknown. And this topic wasn't handled by politics, because politics thought that it was the best way of avoiding damages. But allow me to thank you and I will say what I think. So first of all, from 2014, this country is building structures of welcome that we didn't have in the past. We didn't use emergencies, we didn't use the decree for civil protection. We refused of doing it without tenders, so we do it in an ordinary way.
Lo pubblico ti mettono sempre dalla parte di quelli bravi, mentre gli altri invece sono quelli.
So I would like you to think about a circumstance that we have today. From the Second World War, we never lived a period of tension like the one we are witnessing today, with terrible scenarios in Ukraine, Syria, Iraq.
In Palestine, and all over Africa. And when I talk about Africa, I mean not only the Horn of Africa, but also Burundi, Niger, and with very difficult situations in Nigeria at the borders with Boko Haram. So this is a situation which has never been seen before, and a humanitarian action, which is the biggest humanitarian operation which this country has ever made, with 170,000 people. Last year, with 72,750 people welcomed on July 3rd. All this is done in ordinary terms. This means it is done without emergency, without the extra which is given with the declaration of emergency, without the provision which allows to take the village of Mineo, because this is what happened in 2011, without transforming a set of Roman initiatives. Let me say something else. Here we have 60 million inhabitants, more than 8,000 municipalities. We have 81,000 something people, plus minors, not accompanied minors, more than 90,000. But do you really think this is something serious? Or this is just the result of the politics which instrumentalizes this? And what is the figure? What is the figure of crimes that these people arrived in Italy made? I would like to know how the quality of security in Italy has changed, if not in the mind of those who have been played on these issues and have used the politics. The responsible person of the Messaggero called me yesterday. He insists by saying, "Who's the guilty person? Why in Treviso to?" Guys fainted, etc. And I told him, what do you want from me? The Veneto region welcomes almost 5,000 people. So now tell me, seriously, if Veneto is able or not to welcome 4,500 people. This is what we are talking about. So the shame belongs to the institutions of that region. It is not the shame of the system. As Gad Lerner was saying, honestly, I am very surprised because a huge humanitarian operation has been done. Of course, bad things happened, corruption happened. I believe that Expo, there were problems. Also, we have also other examples, such as Moses. So why is Mafia Capitale the only problem? This is not the only problem. Anyway, I'm not here to do like a politician's speech. I'm just passionate because I decided to go back and do this job in a time when I had an extraordinary commitment. My life has been enriched, but it's complicated. So let's see the situation. A unified conference took place last July, in which regions that have no competences but which have the programming of the territory, they have a role of general coordination. To be there, the municipalities, the representatives of municipalities decided to share the burden of this extraordinary welcome all together, and this will be part of our history, because it will be part of our history, this situation of the immigration. What type of country is a country that decides signs something, but then he declares, no, my counselor was not there, I didn't sign? Well, honestly, I'm really concerned Lombardy, just to talk about Lombardy, and afterwards we will talk about Milan. Milan is something different because it is a magnet, just as Rome is a magnet for those who want to leave. But don't make this mistake, because this is another bad information. The people who are at the station of Milan and causes a problem, just like the people who are at the station of Roma Tiburtina or the people who are in Ventimiglia, they are people who didn't, were not rejected welcome. They do not want to stay in welcome for legitimate reasons. They want to go to the United Kingdom, to Germany, to the Netherlands. I also discovered that the Danish ambassador gives 4,000 euro to a family of four people. So I go to Denmark, and they give 4,000 euros. So this is extraordinary. So Lombardy welcomes 8,451 people. Lombardy, which has a GDP bigger than Greece, which has 10 or 12 million people, I don't remember, 10 million people. They so Lombardy welcomes. Don't tell me about legal migrants who are already on the territory and contribute to the GDP of Lombardy. They pay the taxes of Lombardy. So honestly, and I don't want to go further, if you want, we can talk about Dublin and wherever you want to talk about, but we must talk about minors. Honestly, you understand very well that the issue is just an issue linked to the consensus, to the political dimension of our institutions. And when I talk about political dimension, it's because they taught me that the political leader leads the way for the future, and let me understand why we make some decisions. It doesn't meet, it doesn't respond to the fears of people, just as somebody else before me said. But now it seems that politics is made differently. It is made by responding to the worst fear of people. Only in this way we achieve consensus, whereas the solitude of those who have to explain the reasons and must have the vision of the future and must get convinced about the future is not present. Well, but this is these are just a few words that I'm saying as a citizen, but I shouldn't say them in my quality as an officer of the country. Anyway, minor, and I have to talk about this and Sicily region. The Minister of the Interior didn't want to know anything about minors, starting from the 1st of January 2015, because until the 31st of December 2014, didn't do anything about minors. I don't want to know who was there in 2014. I don't want to know this, but they didn't arrest anyone. For what happened in 2014 in Sicily, people had to go to jail. For that which happened in Augusta, people had to go to jail. No one went to jail, but then they gave us this issue of not accompanied minors. And then there is another problem. Accompanied minors, well, these favors the growth of some decisions and positions of many people. So there is an old law of 2000 which must be overcome. Now there is a proposal of law which is never approved, etc., etc. So the substance is, at least until 31st December 2014, minors were entrusted with mayors, and this was a terrible situation. Do you know how much, according to them, cost a not accompanied minor. It costs 80 euro per day, or in some municipalities 110 euro per day, so 3300 euro per month. So what Italian family can allow for such an operation, can spend for their children 3300 euro per month. So what was that money used for? So starting from the 1st of January, we have decided that we pay 45 euro per day, and we don't care. And I'm saying this as a friend, that Sicily region has decided that for 10 regions plus two, there must be eight operators, one graduated in pedagogy and something else. We cannot afford to have 10 minors plus two in a family center with eight operators 24 hours per day or 12 hours per day. I'm not saying this only about Sicily. This is not possible. Then there will be, of course, the child who has been subject to abuses. Well, we are all ready to do as many sacrifices as possible, but on a Nigerian a kid who's 18 who pretends to be 17, how can we bear all this? Do you think this is easy? Or do you imagine this is easy to achieve the result to pay 45 euro per day? I am really dealing with a war, a conflict, because I want to pay 45 euro, and I will pay 45 euro. And I'm going to conclude, then you will respond wherever you want to respond. Well, in Turin, Turin pays 110 euro. I fought with the vice mayor of Turin. And also Lombardy. When we repeat, I don't want you to waste time, because I have a friend and I want to meet him for dinner. When the Minister of the Interior launched the tender, and the money of the ministry are certain, sometimes they can arrive with some delays, but they are certain. But it's certain money. So we said, build first welcome houses and centers. Then we also launched the project SPRAR for not accompanied minors, where there can be 50 minors. So in these shelters, Sicily authorized four structures. Calabria responded with one or two structures, Puglia, Campania, Emilia-Romagna. Do you think that Lombardy or Piemonte or Veneto responded? No, they didn't. I believe that if there is the SPRAR, which is a best practice, which no one can question, if Lombardy decided to participate, and I'm not talking about Milan, which is a different reality, it's a metropolitan city which has 1,000 problems, I understand this. And for this reason, as much as possible, I try to support big realities such as Milan and Rome because of the complex problems that they have to face. But there is the rest of Italy which I have troubles understanding. I understand that I have to conclude, because you are looking at me not in a very nice way. Anyway, I would like to say a few words on the Juncker agenda. Because Gad Lerner was mentioning this, a great journalist, very smart, but it is easy to launch bombs in the audience and then to leave. Well, the issue is, it's true, we are subject to a awful pressure, especially on Dublin and identification from the European Union. There was this strong initiative by the Commission and some commissioners, which is called the Juncker Agenda, and on which there has been a debate. Of course, there is On one end, there are countries which are open to so European solidarity, the Treaty of Lisbon, which is one of the principles which are neglected in the Treaty of in the Declaration of Dublin. Then there were countries like Hungary, which had decided to establish a wall, but has changed its mind. Some friends, like French, well, French who didn't want to send us a Piperno because they had doubts on our constitutional guarantees. How do they, how can they do this? And it is the attempt is this one. The famous 8th spot, I don't know if you read it on the newspaper, in the hotspot, we should identify the migrants according to your French, and we should apply a kind of repatriation to the border, which we do not want to apply, or take them enclosed until they decide to go to their house. But what I want to say, and this is something I say in public, our constitutional values cannot be touched. We had a lot of troubles in the last 10 years. We tried to improve the quality of the guarantees, supporting our migrants. Migrants are people, they are not objects, they are not goods, commodities. So we will do this according to our national legislation, according to our constitutional guarantees, and we will not allow for an alteration of the values which are at the basis of our civil coexistence and at the basis of the dignity which is so much described by the citizens of the north, or the northern part of Italy.
Scendo dal palco e prendo un solo impegno.
So I take just one commitment. I'm used to overcome the Gothic line from this point of view. As I smoke a cigarette with Mr. Morcone outside, and we already discussed a few things, and by accepting the proposal by Mr. Maiorino, whom I know for many years, and addressing Cesare Maciano, who represents better than me the Expo issue, and Mrs. Pavese, who represents the G6, well, I didn't know that there were so many authorities listening to me. Well, I commit myself, together with Guazzetti, La Gadlerner, and the other friends, to relaunch this topic. So in September we will meet again, and I hope that Sicily region will always be next to me as per this topic, so we can meet again at the Expo, because as I said yesterday in an interview at Corriere della Sera, I believe that we must go beyond this thematic park. We will leave this area, and everything will be okay, but the real topics which are underlying and which we must analyze more in depth are many, so I will communicate when we can meet in September. Maybe we can include it in the Charter of Milan. Well, of course, I'm going to talk to Salvatore Vecca. I've already told the minister that these are topics that we must include in the Charter of Milan, which has a bit skipped this issue. The problem is not only the Charter of Milan, but it is the practice and how we can close, if we can, the fault places. I'm very concerned about this because I share The discussion of today has been very deep, but if you allow me, the conclusions are not very optimistic. So let's think about this very well, because the faults start to appear in our lexicon. And when they start to appear in our lexicon, and when we say it's not mine, we must get concerned. Counselor, you can give the conclusions, and I will be very, very brief. I think that in our debate today, we have underlined two profiles. One highlights the emergencies and the management of emergencies, and the other one, which concerns the long profile and the management, long-term management of these issues. The two profiles are intertwined. I start from a statement given by Emma Bonino many months ago. At the other end of the shore, the problem exists. You cannot go and shoot on the boats before they leave or before they arrive. The problem exists, and when you so the problem exists, and we cannot imagine to find buffer solutions because the problem can explode on another in another part. So the long profile is needed also for this. So Salvini came to Sicily, but he found someone who followed him, but actually he was not followed by anyone. So I come from the UNESCO, where we celebrated the international recognition of the Byzantine Arab Norman of Palermo, Monreale, and Cefalù. In the motivation of the UNESCO, we can take the sentence, the statement in the presentation of this conference. In Sicily, several people have coexist, and so we have this mixture. And there was an explosion of consensus. The consul who represented Italy told me that such an enthusiasm was not expected by all participants. So the acceptance of this, and someone also said, why have you thought about this so late? Because someone said, I see what I see, and it's like an Arab city. But my question is, we have made integration between Islam, European culture, a museum in the great cultural elements. But what is the teaching of today? That synthesis was not a synthesis made of kisses and hugs. It was not the synthesis of an unpainful process. They called each other and they said, okay, let's build this. You put a stone, you put a mosaic. It was a very hard, a very difficult process, full of conflict. At the end, this syncretic approach between different religions, different cultures came out, and this big heritage. But we cannot leave of musealization. But that's an experience which today must be made current. So these are not unpainful experience processes, but they are processes which have a value and make us grow. So it opens us to a long-term vision, which is that of opening and integration. So Bishop Mugavero was mentioning the identity challenge, who we are, the world which opens thanks to globalization and stays inside our scope and external globalization. But if it comes to your house and takes the aspect of people coming from the sea want to take part in the development, which was refused to them. Well, new models, new population, they bring different religions arrive. So uncertainty and fear explodes based on this challenge. And the main point is that the world is changing.
Con la Caritas noi portavamo i beni loro.
There are people who say we want to take part in the process, we want to be serious interlocutors. They want to be important pieces of the developed world. So fears must be managed and also uncertainty must be dealt with. When China started to bring here the Made in Italy products, someone proposed custom duties and so on. Actually, a leadership position can be conquered. Maybe we can all gain from this. I don't want to be a historical optimistic person. There are walls, as Gerd Lerner was saying, but for many years the south of Italy has not been the focus of economists and politicians. In the past, people used to say, without the south of Italy, we cannot start. So if the wall is there, southern Italy is behind that. A great Italian economist said 5 years ago, the line stops between Florence and Ancona. Below that line, you can take care of your business. Try with tourism, try with agriculture, but this is something which is no longer compelling. We cannot imagine a development which includes the South in a growth which interests the whole country, because the North looks at Central Europe, looks at the productive aspects, at wider markets. Then the long-term vision also says that there is an economic wall in which the South is out. It is at the other. It is at the other side of the Mediterranean. So, what shall we do that live below that wall? To build the Mediterranean man. We must understand what European Union has done and does. European Union has managed in a not correct way the relationship with the Mediterranean area. It managed some conflictual position, as in the 70s and 80s there were productive structures. If we take the productive structures of the Mediterranean countries of Greece and we compare them with the southern regions, there is a qualitative overlapping, which is evident. We are regions which have the same development model and the same sectors which are in competition. And the European policy has managed the conflict, has neutralized the conflict with relationship which were multilateral, but actually they were ex-colonies and a colonizing actor. France was the dominator of Tunisia and so on. So there has never been a vision of inclusion. So what does it mean to say Euro-Mediterranean? What is the border of Euro-Mediterranean? The south of... So they say Europe stops here before the south of Italy. And so take care of your business. So we need to talk about the development model of the Mediterranean area. European Union softens the differences between northern and southern part, because the market is global and the Mediterranean macro area is a destination which is a single macro destination. So let's just think of one of the strands which we see. I don't believe in the long-term strands. We have a real strand. We have a macro region which can impose a development model, especially of cultural tourism, which can offer itself to the international market. So we must strengthen cross-border policies in the field of research and valorization. Let's build a model which is a model of development of tourism, which is based on relational culture, the culture of welcome, which is one of the best heritage of this region. Let's try to make some step forward in this sense. So a Mediterranean model. How many heritage of humanity are present in the southern part of the Mediterranean? A lot. So let's try to think of to work with university networks. We must establish high level education education programs. So let's say we are at the other side of the world, okay, but we can also let the wall be perforated, because university networks are not closed. They have a structure which is open to the whole world. They bring and accept knowledge and transform it. So let's use a set of opportunities which already exist, the global chain values. There are also the Mediterranean, and Sicily is at the center of three continents. There is a movement of goods which cross the Mediterranean Sea towards and from East Asia, which we can intercept. So let's reflect from this point of view without, and so let's accept. Let's try to build a development model, self-sustainable, which has the legs to move along in a bigger, in a wider area, which is a global market, and let's work on a globalization world. Of course, it is difficult. Of course, we have many difficulties because of the emergencies, as the prefect was saying. There is not much consensus. I understand it is very difficult to manage this process and to build the consensus which will probably facilitate many solutions. But meanwhile, let's work in the long term. So this is a reflection that I would like to suggest you. As far as we are concerned, we're moving towards this direction, that is to use the heritage we have to give value to tourist flows, but we are open to a collaboration within the Mediterranean area and in southern Italy to give to make a growth journey more concrete, and this could also soften many tensions. Thank you. Have a nice evening.
No, il mio cluster è micidiale, è da svenimento. Bene.